Hi and welcome to this Texturino tutorial. I'm Alice and this episode will show you how to overlay texture using Texturino and an opacity mask. Using a textured overlay instantly softens vectors, creating a vintage look.
Overall, we'll cover overlaying a texture and using an opacity mask to eat away at artwork. So I have my finished artwork and I want to give it a vintage feel by overlaying a crumpled paper texture on top. I'm going to lock all of my artwork to keep it safe. I'm going to create a new layer for my texture. As the texture tool deals with live effects, I have to have a fill of some sort in order for the effect to show. So I'm going to create a white square, the same size as my artboard. And apply my crumpled paper texture. See how, no matter what opacity mode I use, I cannot make it transparent. That's because, if you remember, our square had a white fill. We need to switch to the Select tool and select the square again. Then change the opacity of the whole shape, not just the texture. To do this, we need to click the opacity on the top bar and change it to Multiply. See how all the white sections of the crumpled paper have become transparent, leaving just the shadowy textures. In this case, I would be tempted to use the texture brush to remove some of these darker areas. Do check out the later videos where I cover this. To get the effect of the texture eating away at my artwork, I need to use an opacity mask. In this case, I want to apply a vintage effect to this live text and the vector path underneath. I've already locked the background to make things easier. Then I need to select both and group them together. And add my texture. You can just about see the texture has been applied. Let's try changing its opacity, which is okay, but not quite what I was after. So what I need to do is change my selection to a white fill. Notice that the texture is still applied, and then create a separate square to contain my intended blue fill. Making sure it's placed behind our original group. Then select both and go to your transparency panel. If you haven't got it open, it can be found in the window menu. Then click Make Mask in order to make your opacity mask. And there we go, we have the final effect. Let's zoom in and have a closer look. What's important to remember is that if you want to edit your texture, you need to first of all tell Illustrator that you want to edit the opacity mask by clicking on the mask thumbnail in the transparency panel. Then you will be able to use your texture tool to make any changes. I'm going to try out my grimy glass texture. There we go. If we take a closer look at the mask thumbnail, you can see the white areas allow the blue fill to show through, and any black areas become transparent. Also, check out how your layers tell you you're editing your mask still. To stop editing the opacity mask, just click on the artwork thumbnail, which in this case contains my blue square. What's great is that this is completely editable. I just need to make sure I enter the Edit Mask mode first before I make any changes. To delete the mask, just click Release, which will return it to its former state. So there we have it, two very different texture effects that transform artwork from vector to vintage. That's it for this tutorial. Overall, we've covered overlaying a texture and using an opacity mask to eat away at artwork. Check out the next tutorial in order to understand how to import textures into the texture panel.
All our plugins are available for free trial via our website, astutegraphics.com.